from New York City, America's financial capital, this is In the Money.
We've all had tense moments at one time or another with our boss. I know it's probably surprising
moments,
to think that
yes.
that would happen with me, but it has. When you dread going to work each day, though, because the guy or gal in the corner office yells and insults you, it may be a sign your boss is a bully. Our next guest calls this kind of workplace abuse a silent epidemic. And he's not only trying to raise national awareness about it, he's trying to make it illegal as well. Dr. Gary Namie is the founder of the Workplace and Bullying Institute, and he joins us now to talk about this new book, The Bully at Work. Welcome. Nice to have you with us.
Thanks, guys. Thanks.
How many of these creeps are out there?
One in six people are affected. I'd say maybe one in ten. One in ten bosses are bullies.
Wow.
We really don't know. Funny, the companies don't let us go in and measure it.
But don't we have, aren't there like HR departments and all these civil rights laws and all kinds of social protections for against abuse built into the system that should sort of preclude these creeps from plying their trade with us poor workers?
Isn't it amazing? Here we are on just past the 40th anniversary of civil rights law, and everybody thinks harassment's illegal, but actually only for a very few. And so, no, there's very little legal protection. And boy, you mentioned the heart of the problem, and I'm sorry to say it. We love HR people who care about bullying, and those are the ones that bring us into corporations. But most of them like to blow it off and discount it. They just treat the people who make the complaints as, they treat them as troublemakers, whiners, complainers, and they say just grow a thicker skin, which of course is the wrong attitude to take in this, because bullying, folks, is the business's costliest secret too.
Hey, Gary, I'm very anxious to talk to you because over the course of my career, I've had the pleasure of working for several jerks, weasels, martinets. And if you're watching out there, I think you know who you are. My question is...
Fill in the blank.
Yeah. Do these people succeed or do they eventually get their comeuppance? I guess what I'm asking you is life fair?
Yes, they do get promoted, and no, it's not fair. We've actually got statistics on that only 9% of bullies ever get their comeuppance.
9% of bullies. I like that statistical approach you got. 9% of bullies get
only 9% of bullies comeuppance. That's a technical term, comeuppance.
Okay.
You used it.
Yes.
But the once a person's targeted, 70% of them lose their job. So no, that's not quite equitable. It's not quite fair. And the funny thing is, these tough clowns think that they're good managers, and you know they're not. They violate every tenet of good management. But the issue is that they get away with it totally. They bully with impunity, and they're just too expensive to keep. But the companies need to sit down and do the write-ups. Look at the turnover. Look at the disability costs. Look at the damaged reputation. And then maybe if you have a compassionate inkling in your soul, you'll actually consider how the individuals who are targeted hurt. And I'm talking about PhDs, MDs, and a whole bunch of professional people who get dinged and turn into basket cases. They become traumatized. They go right from anxiety, depression, to trauma. It's crazy. It's crazy making. These people, they're funny to laugh at, especially the screaming Bobby Knight types. But truth be told, they're eroding American business, and we got to stop them.
Well, and I'm going to follow up on Andy's question, is life fair? Because perhaps there is a bit of fairness in seeing all those corporate criminals, white-collar corporate criminal perp walks. Don't you think that perhaps that these CEOs who were once lionized as these rock stars almost in the 90s, like the Dennis Kozlowskis, Bernie Ebers, Al Dunlops, you name it, in fact, they could have been bullies themselves in a way that it sort of inhibited employees from blowing the whistle.
Absolutely. If indeed, I think the perp walk does provide some satisfaction. But the truth is, if bullies are psychopaths, and very tiny, tiny, tiny fraction are, because by the definition, psychopaths can't stand routine. The only people who could be psychopathic and still work are CEOs. They have complete freedom. They don't work a 9-to-5.
Right,
they don't work a 9-to-5. And everybody else is tethered to their desk and their job, see? And so I hope it brings some satisfaction. But most people are too wounded to see it. It needs to be highlighted more. There needs to be more follow-up.
What is a person to do, though? You just said that a lot of the HR departments just write this off as, all right, we'll put your complaint in a file someplace and nothing will be done about it because, hey, the boss at the end of the day is that. He's the boss. And if you want to get too frisky in voicing your complaints, you could find yourself on the unemployment line, and we all know what kind of a job market's out there these days. So if I've got a jerk or a weasel, as Andy so colorfully described him, that I'm reporting to, realistically, what can I do about it?
We've got a three-step model for individuals. That's what we highlight in the book, The Bully at Work. It's written for individuals. We're writing the employer book now based on some of the corporate things we're doing in terms of policy. But right now, you're basically a lone gunslinger against a Goliath. So here's what you got to do, the little Davids in the world. One, you got to name it. By naming it, you gain strength and you externalize the source of your problem. You know it's not you. Two, you've got to take time off to consider the legal ramifications, get some mental health counseling, and gather some data. Step three is the data that you have gathered, you're going to use to expose the bully. What you're going to do is you're going to make a business case, not an emotional case, not a psychological case. Nobody wants to hear about the conflict or the pain that you're in. But the business needs to be confronted with at the highest level, CFO and finance people and risk managers. Do you care about the liability these jerks are bringing? Yeah. And if they don't, get out.
I like the fact of telling us to get mental counseling. I think that's very appropriate. Quick last question. Any businesses worse than others?
We find that most of the complaints to us come from healthcare and the public schools. School bullying couldn't happen if it weren't embedded in a place where teachers beat up kids and superintendents beat up teachers.
Whew, so glad that news organizations weren't high up on the list. Maybe you need to check into that.
Second dirtiest secret.
Gary Namie, who is on a one-man crusade to eliminate bullies in corporate America. We wish you a lot of luck here on In the Money.
Thank
He's also with the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute. Thanks for joining us.